Now let us learn the third property of the lanthanide elements, that is atomic and ionic radii. It is also called as the lanthanoid contraction. When we plot a graph of the atomic or ionic radii of all these 14 elements, then we obtain such graph. Now this graph is of the ionic radii, Li3 plus. Li means lanthanide plus 3 states, and these are the elements having the plus 3 state, and this is the radius are given in picometer. Now see here, as we move in the series from lanthanum to lutetium, what happened? That is the plus 3 state radii, that is the ionic radii, gets decrease and decrease, and finally in lutetium it obtain the lowest value. Now as we move along the lanthanide series, there is a decrease in the atomic or ionic radii, and this steady decrease in atomic and ionic radii is called as the lanthanide contraction. Now what is lanthanide contraction? Lanthanide contraction is nothing but the steady decrease in atomic or ionic radii in the lanthanide series from lanthanum to lutetium is called as the lanthanide contraction. Now what is the region of this lanthanide contraction? As we move from one element to another element, we know that the nuclear charge increases by one unit. That means this serenium have one proton more than the lanthanum. Again the prasmodium have one proton more than that of the serenium. In this way atomic number increases, that means by one unit the nuclear charge also, that is the number of protons are also increases by one unit. And at the same time one electron is added. As one proton increases, there is definitely increase in the one electron also. But that one electron which is added is in the same subshell, that is the 4F subshell. Thus the new electron is added to the same 4F subshell. Remember that. And thus the 4F electrons shields each other from the nuclear charge very poorly. Now see here, as the electrons are added into the same 4F subshell, what happened there? What happened? Because the electrons are added into the same shell, but the nuclear charge increases. Shell is remains as it is. That means these 4F electrons shield each other from that nuclear charge very poorly. Means due to diffusive nature of the 4F orbital, diffusive nature, that means it is also having the 4F orbital also have the lobes. It is not spherical orbital as that of the S orbital. So due to the diffusive nature, the electrons into the 4F orbital are shielded very poorly from the nuclear charge or experience of the nucleus. That means nucleus attracts that 4F orbital more closer and closer to itself. Due to that, what happens? Size gate decreases. Now see here, due to the diffusive nature of the 4F subshell, so the nuclear charge experienced by each 4F electron is increased. Nuclear charge experienced means nucleus attract the 4F electron, 4F orbital more closer and closer to the nucleus, and what is this increases as a result, and as a result whole 4F shell contracts due to the increase in the effective nuclear charge and it's experienced on that 4F electron. What is there? There is contraction in the 4F orbital, contraction in the size of the 4F orbital. All the 4F orbital, whole 4F orbital get contracts at each successive element. and this is called as the lanthanoid contraction. Now this is the lanthanoid contraction. I'll always ask into the examination, what is lanthanoid contraction, and this is the answer. Now see here, all the elements as we go from left to right into the lanthanoid series, their ionic and atomic radii get decrease and decrease. This is due to the very deficient nature of the 4f orbital, very poor shielding of the 4f electron to each other from the nucleus, again increasing the nuclear charge which contract the shell, and in this way the size of the atomic and ionic radii in the lanthanoid decreases. Now this is nothing but the, this is called as the lanthanoid contraction. Thank you.